motivated by folks that ain't got the Holy Ghost. Because when you got the real Holy Ghost, it just don't make you speak in tongues. But the real Holy Ghost will tell you, you need to block them. You ain't got the real Holy Ghost. Because you dance and shouting and still with somebody else's name. You don't like me to hear. The real Holy Ghost will tell you, listen, with that tongue you speak, you using that same tongue to heal somebody else. That Holy Ghost will make you shut up and go somewhere. But you're going to grab your neighbor by the head and ask him, do you really have the Holy Ghost? All right. So some of y'all saying, yeah, it's not the wrong voice, but some of y'all got too many voices.
Come on, man.
You got 10 spiritual problems.
You preaching.
You preaching. You got all these people that are in your ear, and this is the problem with that. After a while, when you got too many voices, the voices shift from voices to noise. So now you don't know who to follow because you got too many voices in your ear. Because every voice wants something from you. You better get some people in your life that if you can't never pay them, they'll still pour into you. Let me let you know something. If it takes a payment and a kiss up to get them to pour into you, that's not your pastor, that's a sugar daddy. And we are picking folks by making them pay to be close to y'all, though, right? But you ain't a real leader until they can't promise you nothing, but you're willing to give them everything. Oh, pastor, it means that sometimes they can't give me a dime, but I am willing to do what I got to do to see the people of God blessed. You can't be a leader because you're too selfish, because you want the glory and the credit. But sometimes being a leader said they ain't going to call my name when they really need help. And I'll pray with them in the midnight hour. They ain't going to say the real truth. But the God that sees in secret shall reward you openly. My God, your neighbor say, payday is coming after a while. This is a familiar pattern of scripture. I'm about to move on because I feel the Holy Ghost coming upon me.
That's all right.
The Bible teaches us that Jesus, hallelujah to God's name, he constrains them to get into the ball. I feel my stride now. The Bible says that he constrains them. In other words, he forces them to get on the boat. And the next thing they know, when they get on the boat, here there is a storm. Isn't it amazing that God puts them into trouble? How can I preach in here? Sometimes you can be serving God and still find yourself in trouble. I wish I had some people in here that you paid your tithes and your money still started acting crazy. You was an all-night prayer. And when you got up off your knees, you still had hell to deal with. Let me let you know something. Every storm don't come from the devil. I wish I had somebody I could preach to here. But sometimes he leads us into places to develop our character. But you didn't know us. Every time they didn't show up, it was God pushing you to a storm. Every time they didn't listen to you, he was pushing you into a storm. Because we're going to say, God pushed you there. If we read the text, the text says that while they are constrained to go into the ship, Jesus is on the mountains praying. Can I talk in here? Isn't it amazing that while they're in the most scary situation in their life, Jesus is on the mountain making intercession for them? Which means that just because you can't see him doesn't mean there ain't no activity going on in the realm of the spirit. I want you to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I can't see God. I can feel, God. But if I know him like I think I know him, he's doing something behind the scenes. I preach a little wrong something here. I preach to myself tonight. Somebody can't see your way out. You don't know what God is doing. But look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, he's working it out behind the scenes. You ain't got no money. He's working it out behind the scenes. No devil ain't got any power. He's working it out behind the scenes. Look at your neighbor. Have another hold.
So he punches him into the stone.
Yes.
Because he's got to show them a side of them that they've never seen before.
Uh-huh.
And because many of them were spirited and not spiritual.
Come on.
The difference.
Come on.
Because some of y'all are spirited and not spiritual.
Uh-huh.
What is the difference? It's when you always see everything as a spirit and can't recognize the spirit.
Help us!
Did you know a demon when you see him, but you don't know God when he hits you?
Y'all are slow in here. I'm going to go home and watch Game of Thrones. The issue that I got with many of the saints in the room is you can call everything a demon, but you don't know how to act when real glory hit the room. That's how I know you want to cast out the devil out of everybody, but you got your arms folded during place of worship. You're not spiritual. You're spiritual. You only say something when your favorite preacher is preaching. You are spiritual. You're not spiritual.
Hallelujah.
We got too many people on a witch hunt instead of a God chase. You don't like being here. Did you hear what I just said? Some of y'all are on a witch hunt and not on a God chase. When you're on a God chase, even when the witches come, you ain't focused on the witch. You're focused on the glory of God. Look at your neighbor and say, let's get that focus on the glory.
Hallelujah.